also developing right now a balloon release in Little Village at the scene where Chicago police shot and killed a 13-year-old boy. Those at the vigil calling for peace and justice for Adam Toledo. The Chicago Police Department is changing its foot chase policy 1 week after that shooting. The mayor wants a new policy in place by summer. Our Tara Molina is always investigating and learned the policy in the works well before the shooting. It already was. Tara joins us now live. Tara.
Brad, in the most recent report from the independent monitor that's overseeing the court-ordered review and reform of the Chicago Police Department, they found that this policy, this foot pursuit policy, was recommended back on March 5th. That's more than 3 weeks before the shooting here even happened.
Officers must make split-second decisions when it comes to the use of deadly force, and that is a heavy burden.
A chase and an armed confrontation led up to the split-second deadly decision made in this Little Village alley last Monday when a Chicago police officer shot and killed 13-year-old Adam Toledo, who was armed, according to Mayor Lori Lightfoot.
Tragedies like these also underscore the urgency of reforming CPD's foot pursuit policy, not tomorrow, but now.
With chases happening across the city every day of the year,
foot pursuits present a significant safety issue.
Mayor Lightfoot says since the chase here, she's told Chicago police they have to come up with a new policy before the summer hits.
The superintendent has already begun the process. There'll be focus groups from officers, focus groups from the community to strike the right balance and looking at best practices from across the country.
Mayor Lightfoot said the consent decree put this issue off for several years, but we found there were instructions for review and reform in place before the mayor's orders and before this shooting. In the latest progress report on the reform of CPD, a result of the court-ordered consent decree, the independent monitor wrote, quote, "We recommended that the CPD adopt a foot pursuit policy. It is our understanding that the city, the CPD, and the OAG either agree with or understand the need for a foot pursuit policy. The call for a new policy and soon comes as we learn more about what led up to the shooting and why it took 2 days for Chicago police to get in touch with the Toledo family after Adam was killed. According to Police Superintendent David Brown, the 21-year-old man who was with Adam during the shooting gave officers a false name for the 13-year-old. Adam had no ID on him. His mom had reported him missing Friday night, but told police he returned Saturday. After the shooting early Monday, his mom did not report that he was missing again. Now, COPPA has said the body camera video of this shooting can and will be released to the public, but they're waiting right now on the review with the family. Now, we've checked in with COPPA today. We've checked in with Adam Toledo's family's attorney to see when that video review is set to happen. Tonight, we still don't have a firm answer on that. Brad?
And of course, sources telling CBS2 investigators what they will see in that video will be disturbing. Tara, what did Mayor Lightfoot say about the video when she spoke about the case for the first time today?
Brad, Mayor Lightfoot was asked about this directly, and she claims she still hasn't seen the video. She says she's waiting on the family to review it before she herself takes a look.
Okay. Our Tara Molina. Thank you, Tara.